Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So as you guys can see by the title of this video, this is a collective haul. Now I just want to give a quick disclaimer in that I have literally been collecting this stuff since probably January. I did want to do what I tend to do quite often and do like a seasonal haul, but I'm saving for my wedding at the moment, so I'm not really buying a whole lot of clothes. I kind of just buy it on like the odd occasion. Most of the stuff is like in store buying. There are a couple of things I've thrifted, but I have done a whole big thrift haul recently of everything that I have thrifted whilst living in Auckland. So I'm pretty sure that video should be up by the time this video goes up. So if it is, I'll link it down below, but if not, it's coming soon. There's kind of a mix of like summer and winter pieces in this haul, so I'll try and link down below what I can find. But yeah, I just want to give a quick disclaimer in that probably not everything I show you will be available to purchase. I'm really sorry about that. I didn't just want to let this haul go to waste, if that makes sense. So I have a mixture of accessories, clothing and shoes to show you in this haul. Yeah, if you want to see what I've been buying, then just keep watching. So I might start off with accessories because I only have two to show you. So the first thing that I wanted to share with you guys is this little brown claw clip. So these are like everywhere at the moment. Everyone seems to be like tying their hair up with these. Now I have already got one of these that I bought from Kmart, and it's in kind of that more like classic tortoise shell kind of color, but it doesn't really hold my hair very well, if I'm honest. So I saw this in Glassons and I think it was only about $8 or $9, and I thought I would just try it and see how I went. And this one is a lot stronger and it seems to hold my hair really well. You can get these in a heap of different colors, but I got the brown taupey kind of color because I thought it was quite neutral, so it'll go with a lot of different outfits. Yeah, those are kind of like everywhere at the moment, so I really wanted to like try it out and give it a go. And the last time I wore that to work, I got compliments. And then the last accessory I wanted to show you guys is actually something that I am wearing at the moment. Now apologies, I have not cleaned a lot of my piercings, but I picked up these really nice like cross, like rose gold huggy kind of earrings. I've got like gems all in here, and then it's like a little rose gold cross, and I just quite nice and like tight and small on my ears and just really like delicate. I thought they were really, really cute. Those ones I got from Lovisa and they were on clearance for like $5. They do come in a silver and a gold, but they were only clearancing off the rose gold. By the way, if you guys are curious about my piercings, because I know I've got a lot, I have done a whole video all about my piercings as well, so I'll leave that video down below and in the eye, whichever side it pops up on. And then I think I might move on to shoes. So all of the shoes I'm going to show you today are from Mepiachi. Now Mepiachi is not cheap. They have like leather and suede shoes. To be honest, I probably didn't need a lot of these shoes, but one of the pairs of shoes I did need was a pair of like over the knee boots. So I don't have any over the knee or like thigh high kind of boots. I saw these and I was like, oh my gosh, like I really, really want them. So yeah, it's a mix of leather and suede. It's got a small little heel, and these ones fit like just over my knee. Super duper comfy, and they've got the zip running down. So I'm a size 7 for reference. These ones retail for $580, which I know is a lot. The next pair of Mepiachi boots are on sale, and they are these ones here. Now they are just so fun and different. Again, they're like this red patent leather, and they're very like Gwen Stefani, like early 2000s style, which I really like. The heel is like a croc kind of patent. I did get the sole grips to go on the bottom because the sole is like a resin sole, so it can get really slippery. So the sole grips are only $11, and it has a little zip running down, and it's got the square toe, which is quite fun. I tend to kind of switch up between the point and the square toe, but these ones retail for $360, but they are on sale. If you guys have watched any of my hauls before, then you'll know that I really like playing up with color. When I saw the red, I just like had to have them. Sticking with the color, the next pair of shoes I have are these ones here. Now I fell in love with these. These give me real Barbie vibes and I love it. Like I am all here for it. Again, they're that really nice patent leather. They're just in the pink. They've got the combat bottom, and these ones are super duper comfy. They retail for $380. They're really nice. They are getting quite low on the pink ones though. They're super duper fun and I wear them all the time, and I always get compliments on them when I wear them. And then the last pair of shoes shoes that I have to show you guys that are from Mi Piace are these boots here. So they're kind of just like a white combat style boot. They do actually come with a buckle around here, but I've just taken the buckle off because it kind of like hurts my feet a little bit low-key. But yeah, it's got the laces, but it also does have a zip down the side, so it's really easy to get in and out of. It's got the combat bottoms again. I really wanted a white combat boot. These ones again are nice leather. They retail for $380. They have stretched out quite a lot though compared to when I first got them. And then lastly, we move on to clothing. So I might start with a pair of jeans I need to do up. So I picked up these blue jeans here. Now again, these have been in past videos. They're just like a real nice baggy style. I've rolled the bottoms because they fit better when they're rolled. Two pockets on the front, two pockets on the back. They're kind of like a medium wash of denim, which I really like. These ones are from Kmart, and these ones are called the tapered extra high rise jeans. They're in a size 10. In some of my other hauls, I can't remember which one it is, but one of my other collective hauls, I picked up this exact pair of jeans in a light wash of denim and a black denim. Then they came out with this middle color, which I am obsessed with. This and the other pair of jeans I'm about to show you are probably the jeans that I wear the most, because they're super duper comfy. And they actually have these in like an off-white color as well. But I tried it on and I asked you guys in one of my vlogs for your opinion, and you guys just said you weren't quite big fans of the color, so I didn't end up getting them. But those jeans I actually bought when Phil's dad went into hospital at the beginning of this year. If you haven't been following me for a while, then you won't know, but Phil's dad had a heart attack at the beginning of this year. He's okay, he's recovered and stuff now, but it was very sudden, so Phil and I weren't really prepared, so we kind of just had to like drop everything and go, and we didn't end up packing anything before we left because we went to Hamilton. And it was getting quite cold and it was meant to rain. So Phil and I had to go out and buy clothes. So I bought those pair of jeans. And to be fair, I had actually been eyeing up those jeans. So then I actually needed to go and buy clothing to wear. So I just bought those jeans. So a couple of other tops in here I bought on that same trip. I think they cost me about $22. And then the last pair of jeans that I have to show you guys are these ones here. So again, they're that same kind of style. They're just in a more like lighter kind of wash of denim, and the bottoms I have just rolled. Two pockets on the front, two pockets on the back. These ones are called the straight high-rise jeans. They're from Kmart again. Are we surprised? Probably not. They're in a size 10, but these ones are different to the actual like straight jeans, because Kmart, they have like the little cardboard things over them. These ones are actually called the mum jeans. So if you search for mum jeans, like the actual like word mum jeans at Kmart, these are what you'll find. And I can confirm they're super duper comfy. They fit me a little bit more snug than that other pair of jeans that I just showed you. But yeah, I had heard good reviews about these, so I thought I'd get my hands on them. And like I said before, I wear them all the time. So I think these ones cost me about $22 as well. Sorry, just jumping back to shoes real quick. This was buried and I forgot about these. But I picked up this pair of slippers. I think it was last year from Kmart. But they're this really nice, like soft purple lavender kind of color. Like, I literally cannot emphasize how soft these are. Like, think of the softest blanket you own. They feel like that. Like, oh, I just can't get over them. I got a size 7 to 8, and I think these came in like other colors as well. I don't even know how much these cost me, like under 10 bucks. And slippers was actually the one pair of shoes I did need, because if you guys watched my old updated shoe collection, I said in that video that the only kind of shoe I was missing from my collection was a slipper. So now we move back to clothing. So we're gonna move to tops. So I think I'll show you those two tops that I was talking about that I got when I got those jeans, just because I purely needed a shirt. So again, they're both from Kmart. So the first one I picked up is this kind of like white, I don't know what material this is, but it's really nice and like smart. It does have like a little peep at the back, but it feels really good quality. It's a little bit sheer, so I do have to wear a singlet under this, but I'm not sure what this is called, but this one is in a size 10. This one was on clearance when I bought it. I think it was about 10 bucks. I don't know if you can get this particular one anymore, but it's super duper soft, and then the sleeves are kind of like a little bit rolled. And then the last shirt I bought, just out of pure necessity for needing a shirt, I bought this one because I needed a shirt to sleep in. It is just this like corally rust kind of t-shirt. It's very soft cotton. This one I got in a size 12 because I wanted it to be a little bit more oversized. This one I think was one of their cheap t-shirts. Like I think it was like $5 to $7 or something. And then sticking with Kmart, I got this little like cropped kind of like boxy top. It does have the little pocket on the side, which I think is kind of cute. And yeah, it's got like a thick kind of like crew neck, a really nice like floaty white crop top. You can never have too many white shirts. This one again I got from Kmart in a size 10, made in Bangladesh. I think it literally cost me like $5. You can also get this in a black, but I already had a shirt in my collection that's black with a pocket, so I didn't really need it. And then I may as well show you guys the last white shirt that I got. So I got this white Champion top. It does have the little Champion logo on the sleeve. I'm not sure if this is authentic though, because it doesn't say in here that it is authentic. This is in a size medium, and I literally think I got this from like Cracker Jacks or something. I can't even remember how much it was. It must have been, I think it was like $12 to $15 or something. I've been wanting like a Champion like jumper or shirt for a while, but didn't want to like spend a lot. So next up we might do a couple of tops that I have thrifted. So the first top that I thrifted is this one here. So it's just like a little beige tube top. It does have those little like sticky bits here, so it's not gonna like fall down, and it's gonna give you a bit of grip. It's really nice and neutral, and I've worn this quite a bit, and it's super duper soft and comfy. This one I thrifted when I was in Taradale. Honestly cannot remember any of the op shops that I thrifted these things from, because I didn't write it down in my notes. So this one cost me $3, and it's originally from Cotton On in a size small. So again, I wasn't sure if it was going to fit me, because I don't usually fit Cotton On size small. I'm usually like a medium to large at Cotton On, but it fit me really well. And the last top that I thrifted is this one here. I did actually thrift this for my previous job when I worked in hospital. That's how long this haul has been coming, because I didn't really have any black blouses, and when I did the evening shift for dinner I needed to wear a black blouse. So I found this one. It is a little bit sheer, but I think it's kind of fun. Could be quite nice with like a black bra underneath and some like fun pants if you're going out for dinner. But it's got short sleeves. They're kind of a slight like puff sleeve, which I think is kind of cute. And then it's got this detailing here in the middle. This one is originally the JV Selection Australia. Don't know where that's from. In a size 10, I think from memory, this was under $10. I think it was around the $7 mark. And again, I thrifted this in Taradale when I thrifted that beige tube top, but I cannot remember where from. I'm very, very sorry. But yeah, it's got a little zip running down the back. And it is quite like a high neck. Alrighty, and then the last few tops I'm going to show you, I have all bought within the past month. Most of these should still be available. Now, all the tops I'm going to show you are from Glassons. So this one I've hung upside down so it sits better. So I'm going to show you it this way, even though the coat hanger is upside down. So I bought this cute little like purple strapless top situation with these flowers on. Again, they've got that material in the inside where it will sit and hug your body quite nicely. These bits are kind of like wired in, so that it's not like the most flexible top in the world. And then the back is like fully open and just has this little tie-up situation, which I just thought was so cool and like so different from anything that I own. And I just thought the lace at the front was really nice. This one was on clearance for $10, I believe. So stoked. I literally can't wait to wear that in the summertime. The purple top's in a size 10, by the way. Just forgot to tell you. And then these next two tops I bought together. So I bought them from the like Glassons sale shop in Sylvia Park. The first top I got is this little green one. Now, I thought this was so cute when I first saw it. it's got the little like puff sheer sleeves with the elastic on the bottom. The back is kind of like ruched, I think you guys can kind of see there. And yeah, it has this cute little like tie, and like it's got like stitching for like where your boobs would sit in this top. And I really liked this green color. I don't really own too much in a green. It's got a little zip running down the side, and yeah, it just has these cute little like flowers on it. And I used to have a top when I was little that was kind of the shade of green, maybe slightly a little bit richer, and it had these little like white hearts all over it. So when I tried this on, it just like brought me back to that top as a kid. So I just had to buy this. I think this one was $15. I think it would be nice to wear with like my white like smart pants and maybe those white shoes. The last top I have to show you guys, I've hung it upside down, so it actually goes this way and then this like wraps around your neck. You'll be able to see it a lot better in the try-on shot, obviously. But it's just this really nice like rust color, and it's really like gathered in the middle here. The kids nowadays are wearing these all the time. I just kind of wanted to feel young, so I'm 23 if you don't know. So I really wanted to like throw it back and just buy this. I thought it would be nice for like the summertime, especially because my room gets really hot as it is in the winter. So it's gonna be like a sauna in here in the summer. So I thought it'd be nice if I'm just like editing, just to like chill in a top like this. Or like when Phil and I get married, I can just like lounge around in a top like this at home. It comes in like different colors. Like it came in a black and like a baby blue and a white. I really liked the rust, and rust tends to suit my skin tone really well. This one, again, I got in a medium and it fits me like perfectly. Very happy with this, cost me $10. So next up we have some bodysuits. Again, these are all from Kmart and they're just real like basic. So the first bodysuit that I have is this one here. So it's just like a one-shouldered situation. It is ribbed, I don't know if it's gonna come off on the camera. And yeah, it's just got the little clips down the bottom. I think it was only about 10 bucks too. And I literally wear this all the time. Like you could easily like dress this up with like white pants and a black blazer, or just dress it down with jeans and like sneakers. So, and I liked that so much that I also bought it in the white, so the exact same as ribbed again. Both of them I got in a size 10. Both of them I think were around the $10 mark. And then the last bodysuit that I have to show you guys is this like black t-shirt bodysuit situation. It's a really nice like fitted black bodysuit. It's got more of that like scoop kind of neck, and it goes quite low on the back, which can be really flattering as well. And then yeah, just got the little clips. This one again I got in a size 12. This one I'm pretty sure was on clearance. It came out for like $5 or like $9 or so. I think they also do that in white. So next up I have a bikini to show you guys. So again, I got this from Kmart in like the summer, but it's just that classic kind of like black triangle style bikini. I have one other black bikini, and I actually bought that after I had bought this. It's just that classic kind of like triangle bikini top and your classic kind of black bikini bottoms. But the bottoms were $5 and the top was $5, so it was like $10 for a bikini, which is great. And then yeah, last but not least, we move on to dresses. We'll start with the dress that I thrifted, and that is just this like black ruched strapless dress. I had to get rid of my like lavendery purple strapless cocktail dress because it just got too small, and I'm really sad about it because I really liked that dress. But yeah, this kind of like ruching style has been very in at the moment. It's very stretchy. This one is originally from Supre and it's in a size large, so I kind of knew it would fit because Supre runs quite small. So this one cost me $6, which is very good. And again, I thrifted this in Taradale when I thrifted those other things that I've shown you. Sorry, I did thrift this dress too at the same time that I thrifted that other dress, like thrifted in store piece that I have. Again, you guys have already seen this dress if you've watched one of my videos, and it is just this really nice like lavender and like baby pink spotted t-shirt dress. It's got a little zip running down the back, and I just thought this was so fun. Gorgeous lavender color, which I really love, and I've found it really suits my skin tone. As you can see, this one is originally from Boohoo, and it's a really old Boohoo logo. This one's in a size 12, so I knew it would fit me because that's usually the size I am from Boohoo, because Boohoo tends to run very small. I thought this dress would be really nice with like a tan belt across the middle and some little like white canvas sneakers, and maybe even like a denim jacket. I just thought that'd be such a vibe. So this one cost me $6 because I just thought it was so different, and like you just wouldn't see like the average person on the street wearing this. So yeah, I thought it was so fun and bold, and yeah, a little bit of me. So the next dress that I have to show you guys, I actually just thrifted recently on Facebook Marketplace, and it is lavender again. So it's kind of like the ruche style down here, and it's got this little like gathered bit up the top. The straps are just like not adjustable, and they're just like super duper stretchy. I did actually think this dress originally was from Princess Polly because of what I searched on Facebook. You can get a very similar one from Princess Polly. It's just more of this kind of lavender. I thought this was a really nice like little cocktail dress. I don't really own many of these anymore, but I still like to go out and have a drink like now and then. I'm a little bit curvy than what I used to be, so it definitely hugs my curves. So I think that one cost me, I want to say about $10 to $15 on Facebook Marketplace. And I actually went to go and pick that one up locally. And then the second to last dress that I want to show you guys is another one that I have found on Facebook Marketplace. And to be honest, it's probably like my most favorite thing in this entire haul. And that is just this really gorgeous dress. So if you've watched my Taranaki vlog, which if you haven't, I'll link it down below, my most recent one, I actually wore this dress to Phil's mum's surprise dinner. I just love this. It's got the really nice like puff kind of like sheer sleeves, and it's like elasticated here. It's this really gorgeous like pink color with these little flowers and green leaves. The actual dress itself is like ruched and kind of like gathered in, and it's got a little tie on the bottom that you can like pull it in even more if you need, and it just feels really good quality. It fits me so well, like the length is really good and everything. This one is originally from Princess Polly in a size 10. Now I was a little bit nervous to buy this being a size 10 because usually the dresses at Princess Polly I am a size 12, but I thought because this is quite ruched and stretchy, I thought if it is a little bit like too short it doesn't quite matter because it will like stretch with time. But this fits me perfectly. I think the reason I'm so excited for this is because I saw during Vlogmas last year, and it was this exact dress on Facebook Marketplace, and I had been eyeing it up on Princess Polly, and I really wanted a new dress or a new outfit to wear to my work do. So again, I vlogged that last year. If you want to go and watch it, I'll link it down below. And I messaged the seller and I was like, oh my gosh, is this available? Like, I can come and pick it up tonight. And she told me that she'd sold it and just forgotten to take the listing down. So I was gutted, and I almost bought this like full price off of Princess Polly because I loved it that much. So if I bought this off of Princess Polly, it would have cost me $90 plus shipping. I was kind of just like hoping and holding out that it would come on Facebook Marketplace, and then one day through my searches I found this baby. So I snatched her up, and I absolutely love her. I think this cost me like, I want to say about $20. Probably my most favorite thing, I think, other than my Princess Polly paper bag jeans that I found on Facebook Marketplace, because both of those items I had been eyeing up on the Princess Polly website. And then the last dress that I have to show you, and the last thing in this entire haul, is this dress here. So you can kind of see a running theme with these dresses. I do actually have two other dresses in my wardrobe in this exact style. I just think it's so flattering. But yeah, it's this really nice kind of like yellow and pink and blue and green style dress. This is kind of what it looks like a little bit more up close. Again, it's got the puff sleeves with the elastic. It's not quite like ruched, but it's like that material that grandmas always used to use when they like knit things for you, or like make things for you. The bottom has like a little frill on it. And I bought this last summer from Glasson, so I'm really sorry, but I don't think it's still available. But I got it in a size 12, and it is quite nice and stretchy. Again, I love the colours. I had actually been eyeing this up on the mannequin, because the mannequin in like the window had this dress on, and we'd always walk past Glasson's and I'd always stare at it. And then one day I just cracked and I went in and bought it. So I can't remember how much this was. I think it must have been around like $20 or so. Yes, that is everything that I wanted to share with you guys for this collective haul. I really hope you guys have enjoyed this haul. There's been a lot of good things in this haul, but yeah, again, probably won't do another big brand new collective haul for a very long time. Please give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed it. Please make sure to turn on the notifications and check out my social media. It's always linked down below in the description box. Let me know what you guys have bought recently. I'm really interested to know. I've done a lot of hauls on my channel before, so I'll leave some down below for you to go and check out as well. And yeah, I shall see you guys in my next video. Bye. I cut myself yesterday on the potato peeler and my skin was just like not loving me. Asleep to shirt in. Thrifted. Actually, I need to check how much this was. It just says has blah. Can't even speak. I've been filming so much today. Slayer. Slayer. Shit.